good morning, boys and girls. It is Miss Susan, and Scruffy is actually in the back seat where he is safe, and that's usually where he rides. But I wanted to come to you this morning because I am driving to work, and we have one more week of school, and then we will be out for summer vacation. And you know, driving to work is something that I haven't done a lot this year, because we have been staying safe and we have been in quarantine for this year. And a lot of you know that because you used a computer sometimes to go to school. We didn't go anywhere to go to school. We stayed in our houses and used our computers. So Miss Susan is really excited because in the last 2 or 3 weeks, I have gotten a chance to go in and meet my friends who I only got to see on the computer all year. And it has been so fun because my little children that I get to teach music are just the best. They're excited to see me and Scruffy, and they look at me and we talk to each other even when they're out on the playground. And I'm going to show you that in just a minute as I drive to my school, which is one of the best places in the world, and get to see my little friends. So I have taught in this city for a long, long time. I used to teach bigger kids, but now I teach mainly 4-year-olds. But I thought it would be fun this morning to take you with me on my drive. I'm at a stop sign now, stop light, so I can look at you instead of the road. But I thought it would be fun because getting to go to school is a treat. It's a privilege. And I am very excited that finally here at the end of the school year, Scruffy and I get to go and see our friends face to face. We get to go and make music with them, and we get to sing together and see each other, and it's just really fun. So in just a few minutes, I will be getting closer to my school, and I'll turn the camera around so that you can see my last little turns, and you'll get to see the playground and the sweet school that I get to go and teach with Scruffy. I'll see you in a few minutes. So I'm almost to school, and I wanted to tell you that Miss Susan lives in a kind of a small town. We used to be a mill town, and that means there were big textile mills. Textiles made sheets and towels, and they made towels that were sent all over the world from Cannon Mills. And the name of our town is called Kannapolis. And the really cool thing about it is, if you live in Kannapolis, is that we have a school system that only has one high school. So all of the friends that I am meeting and getting to sing with now, they will go to different elementary schools. But by the time they get to middle school, there's one middle school and then one high school. And it kind of helps our community. Most everybody knows everybody, and it makes for a pretty tight-knit community. So here is my school. You can see there's people on the playground and playing and learning how to get along. There's the big school buses. Miss Susan, pull in here. And then we'll get to go and say hello to my friends. And there's our playgrounds. So, this is where our 4-year-old friends come to learn. Good morning! Hi, guys! Good morning! picture.
Really just found
what did
it's
you
find? It's my tenth phone.
It's somebody's, oh, a cell phone.
It's like yours.
I see that.
And you're the same time. It's like the same.
Wait.
Very good.
I'm
today, Miss Jennifer, I taped myself coming to school because I didn't ever get to do that on our computer. So it was wonderful that our friend said hello.
That's true.
Your shirt has music on it. Look, you have some of the same things that Miss Susan has on my scarf.
It sure does.
Look at that.
So remember at Christmas when we rode the Christmas train? Well, this is our city's train station. And it will say, all aboard! Now leaving for Kannapolis. Toot toot! The name of the train is the Carolinian. So I told you that Kannapolis was famous for towels and sheets. But we also had a famous person that lived here and was born in Kannapolis. And his name was Dale Earnhardt. And he was a very famous race car driver. So I was driving this morning, friends, to school and showing you on the way to work, and I wanted to bring you tonight to the ballpark. So Scruffy's here. Hello, Scruffy. And Alice is here. Hi, Alice. Hello. Oh, look, you got to drive in your car. Hi. Thank you.
Look, it's a dog. Gucci has a ponytail.
Got our fountain. This is our city, my hometown. So if you look this way, our city even put in a little putt-putt course. Parker, we should have brought our golf clubs. Yes, I do. Yeah. Susan used to play tennis up there, but the tennis courts are gone. That's what happens when you get old, Parker. You start saying, oh, they tore down my school. Oh, they tore down my tennis courts. But Jaden,
the boys and girls, the new apartments are going in.
I know, the new apartments. Aren't they cool? Hey. They'll be retail.
Susan's son,
Parker, wants
one of those apartments when he gets out of college.
Jaden, we can...
a little more money than he has right now
that's
to
right,
get one of those
that's
apartments.
Right. Not too bad. You can see all the jokers, Jaden. Yes! I did! Boys and girls, the voice that you just heard was a student that I taught a long time ago who recognized me and Scruffy on our walk, and it just gave me great joy. So boys and girls, do you remember when we came to see the Cannonballers?
By the
Playing ball, and if you look really carefully, you can see our cannonballer. Nice night for a walk.
Boys and girls, we just had a nice walk uptown. There is a ball game going on and all the dogs can come. It's called Bark in the Park. And they've even invited some squirrels for fun. And you can see that Alice is looking at the squirrel really hard. But it's been a nice night for a walk. We're gonna go around the corner and see our newly refurbished Gym Theater. It's where all the people in Kannapolis come to go see a movie, and we're really excited because they're doing some renovations. So we'll see you around the corner, and you can hear the announcers for our ball game in the back. It's a great night to be in Kannapolis. Oh!
Gosh, you can stand here on the corner and hear the church bells. You can hear the music, and then we can also hear the ball game in the background. Let's go and look at the Gym Theater. I wonder if they're selling any popcorn tonight. Oh, it says Go Ballers, which is the name of our team. So recently they have painted the sign. And it looked beautiful and new lights. What does it say on this side? I think our first movie will be Cruella, opening May 27th. And this is where they take the tickets. Wow, hello friends.
Say hello.
waving. Let's see what it says on this side. Oh, it says, congratulations, class of 2021. Parker is a class of 2021. You have any words of wisdom for us to our little friends, Parker, who are going to work hard to graduate one day?
Do your best.
Do your best. Words to live by, boys and girls. Prophetic. Okay.
Does he mean poetic?
Poetic and prophetic. I love to teach here. Did you see how? So a person today that is now 36 years old that Miss Susan taught when he was in elementary school, and he even knew Scruffy. That's pretty cool. So boys and girls, Scruffy and I have been talking a lot about our school year this year and how it was different. Yesterday you got to come with me to school where we get to play and dance and make music with our friends, and we finally got to do that in person. And then last night you got to see all the people in my hometown of Kannapolis. I even have a sweatshirt that has the name of my hometown on it. And you got to see some of the people that I know. And if you remember, we even got to see a student who I had a long, long time ago when I first started teaching. So it gives you a lot of joy and satisfaction when you can talk about your hometown and all the people that you know. And I'm very grateful to live where I live and get to do what I do. And I just wanted to wish you a wonderful summer. And I am so glad that I got to meet new friends this year in different places, right, Scruffy? And we got to do a lot of that because of us being on the YouTube. And as always, we could not have made this year possible and come to see you through YouTube without our friends from the Cabarrus Arts Council and the North Carolina Arts Council, and especially our friends at the Early Childhood Foundation. And we're so grateful. Miss Susan was very sad when I knew we wouldn't be in person for school, but we made it happen. They got us instruments, remember, boys and girls, that we've been able to play at school and in your homes. And they have let us come to see you on YouTube and gotten to do so many different things. We've ridden the train and we've gone to farms. We've seen puppies. We've gone to the ballpark. We've had so many fun adventures, Scruffy. And I thank you for always being my friend and for always being right by my side in whatever adventure that we have. So thank you so much, boys and girls, for being with us this year for music. And we want to thank you for being so awesome. I hope you have a great summer. Tomorrow, Miss Susan and Scruffy are going to do some summertime activities, and we're going to post some things that you might be able to do this summer when you're not in school. So are you ready to sing to our friends? Now it's time for music, music, music. Now it's time for music. We've all had some fun. Music, music, fun, fun. Music, music, we've all had some fun. We've all had some fun. Goodbye, boys and girls. Hope you have a good day.